It's the Mitch Albom Show, live from Lansing on News Talk 760 WJR. At the 20th anniversary celebration of Michigan Virtual, here's Mitch.
You know, I should say that we're broadcasting the celebration of Michigan Virtual 20 years, but we're at the stadium where the Lansing Lugnuts play. Yeah. And it's beautiful.
They played at 10 this morning. They're on a winning streak.
Really?
Yeah, they played this morning. I got the lowdown.
You got all that stuff?
Got the lowdown. They're here
Good
for the weekend.
Good for you, Kenny.
They're here for the weekend,
Heavy
too.
Research.
Yes, heavy research.
Like that.
Yes.
Yeah, so we're looking out on a baseball field here. Meanwhile, we're talking about education. We're going to shift our gears here now and talk about early literacy and getting to kids early on. Four new people have replaced the three previous panelists. And I'm going to allow them to introduce themselves. Go ahead, Ken.
Hi, thank you, Mitch. My name's Ken Durkin. I'm the Director of Online Professional Learning at Michigan Virtual.
My name is Erin Brown. I work for Michigan Association of Intermediate School Administrators. I'm the Professional Learning Grant Coordinator.
My name is Susan Townsend, and I'm the Project Director for the Michigan Association of Intermediate School Administrators, and I'm also the co-chair of the Early Literacy Task Force.
You know, if you don't know, we don't know, so it's kind of up to you.
And I'm Naomi Norman, Assistant Superintendent at Washtenaw Intermediate School District and the co-chair of the Early Literacy Task Force with Susan, as well as a member of the Governor's Pre-K Literacy Commission.
So I know from, we run an academic rec center down in Detroit, and our huge emphasis is on literacy young. I also have an orphanage in Haiti. It's the same exact thing. It seems no matter where you go in the world, if you don't get to kids early on and teach them to read, you can spend the rest of their educational lives trying to catch up. And I imagine we're dealing with some of that in the state of Michigan. Tell us where we are and what are we doing to try to make inroads in that area.
You're absolutely right when you talk about how important early literacy is. In Michigan, one of our big indicators for how we're doing is our third grade scores, as well as our comparison in fourth grade across the country to other states on a test called the NAEP test. And what we found is over the last probably 15 years, Michigan has remained really flat. Our scores are not improving at all, while around the country we see other states doing really, really, really well. So the question is, what can we do as a state, particularly with, as you heard from the previous folks who are here, you know, we're in an interesting place in a state that has incredible diversity. Geographically, we're really quite spread out, rural, suburban, and tremendous control at the local level with how we do education. So we feel that focusing on early literacy is one of the most important things to bring up, not only our scores in Michigan and how our literacy is doing in our students, but also to help us as a state do better relative
to
the other
states.
Well,
what are the other places doing that are enabling them to shoot ahead while we are not?
They're focusing really intentionally.
Let's let some of the other members of the panel talk on this.
Sure. Well, we know that other states have had the opportunity to focus for a long time on specific, explicit practices and stick with it, like our previous group named. And now in Michigan, through the Early Literacy Task Force and through a tight partnership with researchers, we also have chosen to sink into very explicit research-based practices for all kids as a minimum standard of care for every single child in Michigan. And that's what we're here to talk about today.
It would seem to me that if there was one place where you could start even in education, it would be at the earliest level. Because clearly, you know, if you're dealing about trying to deal with kids who are in seventh grade in Detroit versus seventh grade in Grand Rapids, you already have such a disparity of their previous experience. But if you're talking about three-year-olds, four-year-olds, when you're beginning, you get everybody's raw, everybody's new. So shouldn't we be able to find some level that would work in all the different places in diverse Michigan, as you describe it?
That's the beauty of the work that we're doing. We are collectively working together across our state through the Early Literacy Task Force with several partners to really focus on the essential practices, the minimum standard of care, not only for kindergarten through third grade, but birth to third grade, as well as fourth and fifth grade and 6 to 12. So we have a whole comprehensive list of essential practices that every child should have in their classroom every day. And There's no exception for that.
Bear with us 1 second. We're going to do the traffic, and then we'll continue our conversation. Here's Kevin O'Neill.
Thanks, Mitch. Traffic first.
All right, as we continue back here up in Lansing, Ken, let me get you an opportunity to jump in on early literacy. We're talking about the challenges of getting our kids to learn, let's face it, just how to read. I'm sure there are a lot of people who are listening saying, it's not hard. You get a Sally, Dick, and Jane book, and you start to learn how to read. We did it. How come they can't do it? What, if anything, has changed, and what are the particular challenges? And I know from an online perspective, you can share some of that, too.
Well, research has evolved quite heavily over the last decade or so and what early literacy practices should look like. And that's the critical work that Michigan Virtual and the ISDs and Michigan Department of Ed are embarked on, is trying to figure out what those research-based practices are and then bring them to light for every teacher in Michigan. So the online component that we work very collaboratively with is to help show those practices to for free to teachers by... And you can get access to them by going to literacyessentials.org. So teachers have access to this for free. Educators in Michigan have access. And there's a lot of work that's going into those modules to help demonstrate from a really core, solid foundation what you should be doing every day with every child in every classroom.
Answer me just one or two of you very quickly on this. 80 years ago, people had to trace letters. They had one or two basic readers early on, and that was it. Today we have TV shows that can teach you, little computers that kids can play and press buttons that can teach you 1,000 different exciting, fun ways that kids can learn how to read. Why are we behind where we used to be when we had such simplistic tools?
The kids are still learning how to read in Michigan very consistently. The issue is when they're put up against other states at fourth grade, and they not only need to read the text well, but analyze that text, write about that text, compare, contrast, and these higher level skills are what are being assessed of our third graders here in Michigan and of, like Naomi
named.
So
it's not just A is an ah sound and B
right.
is a buh sound.
Our
this
kids
is
are learning to read.
Comprehension.
Yes.
And other issues. Okay.
Absolutely.
Those remain big challenges. Susan, Aaron, Ken, Naomi, thank you for slotting in. More people will sit down with us as we continue from Lansing talking about education. It's 760 WJR.